Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you three tools that every print-on-demand seller should be using. Now, what should make this video very helpful is that not only will I show you what the tools are, but I'll also show you on screen recording how to use them for a print-on-demand t-shirt business. Now, I've been a print-on-demand t-shirt seller for about 10 years now, so I've used just about every tool out there. These three tools are a mix of free and paid tools, and they are the tools that I currently use myself. So with that being said, if you are getting into print on demand, this should be super helpful. And no matter what your budget is, you can still use some or all of these tools. All right, without further ado, let's get straight into this video and start breaking down these tools. So the first tool here is called ChatGPT. Now it's by a company called OpenAI. So if you go to openai.com, it'll bring you right to here. By the way, I'll put a link to all of these tools down in the description so you don't have to go searching for them on Google. But ChatGPT here is the first tool that is entirely free to use. So any of you can use this and all you have to do is come to the website and log in. I'll get logged into my account and I'll show you how to use it. So once you're logged into your account, basically you have an interface where you can ask it questions and you're essentially going to get a response back from artificial intelligence. So the way to think about this is basically if you had an assistant and you said, hey, I need you to do this for me, get back to me when you finish it. ChatGPT is going to use artificial intelligence to do that pretty much instantly. Now, although ChatGPT can answer basically any question that you ask it, the way that we are specifically going to be using it for print on demand is as a brainstorming machine. So the way that we are going to use ChatGPT is to come in here and in the message ChatGPT, say, write me a list of 50 and then fill in the blank. What I like to use is 7 specific overall niches. I'll put them up on the screen here. And that's where I would start. And I'll show you how to go from there. So I'm going to use hobbies. So I'll say, write me a list of 50 hobbies. And then all you do is click enter, or you click this arrow down here. And then as you can see, this is pretty cool. If you haven't used ChatGPT before, it literally writes out the answer for you in just a couple seconds. Now, once we've done this first step of telling ChatGPT to write us a big list of whatever that overall niche is, now we're going to take this information and we're going to use it in our second tool to come up with a really profitable sub-niche that's within these overall general niches. Now, just before we do that, I'm going to give you a little preface. I don't want to get off on a tangent here, but the reason that we are going to take these overall general niches and we're going to break them down into smaller, low competition, profitable sub niches is because over the last few years in print on demand, these really big general overall niches have gotten filled with a bunch of sellers. So if you are just coming in as a new seller and creating a design, there are very low odds that your design is going to be on the first page of these print on demand marketplaces just because of the sheer amount of people selling in these niches. So that brings us right into the second tool that I think is extremely important for print on demand, and I'll show you why. So first things first, let's go to this list and let's look through and see what have you not created a design in, or what do you want to create designs in today? What are you kind of feeling passionate about? What are you interested in? And I'm going to pick one of these. I'll go with fishing. So I'm just going to select fishing. I'm going to right click it and copy it, or just command C on my Mac and that will copy it to my clipboard. And then I'm going to come over to our second tool. So this is the second tool here. It is called Merchantformer. If you've seen any of my other videos on this channel about print on demand, you've probably seen me using this tool because I've been using it for years and you'll see why. Now this is going to be one of the tools that is paid. So I will quickly show you the pricing here. Is they have two plans, $9.99 a month and $19.99 a month. For what we are doing with this tool, you only need the newbie plan. If you are someone who is advanced and you want some extra things, you can get the professional plan. However, two things about the pricing. First is that you can register for free and they give you a 3-day full access free trial. So you can do what we're doing in this video for 3 days and all of that on a free trial. Now, if you do want to sign up for this tool, I have a coupon code from them. I believe it's 20% off. So it brings it down to about $8 per month. I'll put that link down in the description if you do want to sign up. So let me get signed into my account and I'll show you how we use this tool. Okay, so once you're signed into Merchantformer, over on the left side here, you have basically a bunch of dropdowns. All of these are different tools that you can use for print on demand. And they keep adding tools here, so there's a lot of really helpful things. Right now, all we're going to be looking for is the keyword research, and then we're going to go to keyword finder. So from here, go to the keyword box right here, and you're just going to click it, and you're going to paste that general niche that we just copied from ChatGPT. And then just click search. So now we've got some really valuable information for a print on demand seller, just in a couple seconds here. So as I was saying before, the big general overall niches are probably filled. So fishing is probably going to be filled. However, what this tool does in just a couple seconds is it references a ton of print on demand data and it shows you within phishing what are the sub niches that you could go into that have low competition. All we're really looking at is the keyword slash phrase, and then we're looking at the competition. You can kind of ignore this information in the middle. I've tried using it, I've tried not using it, and it really doesn't come into play. All you need to focus on for simplicity is this column here and this column here. Now, what we are looking for is a sub niche that's within phishing that has low competition. That means not many other people are selling in that sub niche. So if we create our designs, we're basically going to go to the first page of the marketplace, and that's where we're going to get our designs seen. So some of these are really not going to make much sense, like phishing. I wouldn't use that. I'm going to keep scrolling through here, just looking for the green ones. And I'll show you this perfect example here. So sometimes even the niche that we typed in, phishing, I just assumed that it was going to be full from experience here. But even phishing, although it gets a ton of search volume, is a low competition niche. So if you're going to create designs in phishing, overall, you're probably in a good spot. However, I would continue through with this from experience, and I would try to get into the smaller sub niches. It's just going to be better for your business long term. So as we keep scrolling through here, you can see bass fishing specifically has medium, but let's keep aiming for the low ones. Angler fishing, those are basically just some keywords. Angler is another way of saying fisherman, but I'm looking for specific things that I can create designs on. So all of these are low here, but I'm not seeing anything that I can click in my head that I can create a design on. Beer fishing, so you can combine the keyword of beer with fishing. That has low competition, so you can go in there. So if you're going to create a design, combine beer with fishing, and now you've got a low competition niche that not many other people are creating designs in. So that's one that we could use right here. Let me just keep looking through here and give you some more ideas. Camping fishing, same concept as the beer and fishing, so you can create fishing, camping, combine both of those into a design. Carp fishing, carp is a specific type of fish, so you can make fishing designs specifically for people who like fishing for carp. And basically what we're doing here is we're scrolling through all of these to figure out what are the low competition niches that we should be creating designs on. So the three that I saw through this list that really stood out to me just in a couple seconds here are beer fishing, camping fishing, and coffee fishing. And what we want to do with this information is we want to, one, create designs that integrate both of those topics. And then two is we want to make sure in the titles and the description of the listing, when we do eventually upload that design to a print-on-demand website, we are including both of those words, coffee and fishing, in the title and description. What that will do is when people are specifically searching for those things, which we now know have low competition, our designs are going to show up and they're not going to get lost in the overall topic of whatever that general niche is. Okay, so keeping this video moving right along here, once we've done that first step of coming up with general niches and that second step of breaking it down into profitable sub niches, now we go back to that first free tool, which is ChatGPT. And now we are going to ask ChatGPT to brainstorm t-shirt slogans that we can use that are copyright free about whatever that profitable sub niche is that we just found. Now, keep in mind, I'm going to show you one example here, but once you have these tools, you can come back and you can search for coffee fishing, you can search for beer fishing, you can search for camping fishing, and just come up with a ton of different slogans. So I'm going to come down here and I'm just going to search for write me 10 copyright free t-shirt slogans about coffee fishing and just click enter. And now ChatGPT has basically done all of the brainstorming for you in just a couple seconds. And a side note here is you don't have to write just 10, you can write 20, 30, as many as you want. Typically when I'm going into a sub niche like this, I'm trying to find just 10 to 40, depending on how big that sub niche is and how many ideas I can really get into, different slogans that I'll turn into designs and upload to the print on demand websites before moving on to the next profitable sub niche. Now, one thing that you should absolutely know about ChatGPT is that it uses artificial intelligence and it gives you really good brainstorming ideas, but it's not always 100% factual. So the way that this comes into play for print on demand is the specific line right here of copyright free. So when you are creating a design, whether that's the slogan, the title, the description for print on demand, you have to make sure that you're not using other people's copyrights or trademarks. That's one of the ways that you can really go wrong in print on demand, because your designs will get taken down. And if too many of them get taken down on your account will basically just be suspended from that print on demand website. So this is one stage that I do take pretty seriously, and I'll show you how I check all of these for copyright and trademark. But there's one step that I'll show you that can just save you some time here. If you just tell ChatGPT, remove the quotes, it's just going to write the same thing again, but it's just going to remove the quotes from that, which will make our next step a little bit easier and save us some time. And we're just going to copy this and come back over to Merchantformer. So as you can see, when you use just a couple specific tools, you can use them for multiple things, and you end up only needing a few good tools to do all of the different things that you need for print on demand. So from here, we're going to go to trademarks, and then we're going to go to trademark alerts. And we're basically just going to click in here and we're going to paste all of that right in the box. Now, as you can see here, these are all 10 of our slogans. And then we're just going to hit save. And then once you hit save, nothing is going to happen yet. It's basically just going to put them down into your entries. So from here, you have to click this button right here that says check trademarks. Just give it 1 second to load here and then refresh your page. And it's instantly going to tell you here if these slogans are actually safe to use. So you don't have to go to the government website and check all of these one by one to make sure that they are safe to use on apparel. All of this is just done for you in a second. So since we got a green check mark on all of these, we can actually use all of these safely. If you did get a red X, that means that you cannot use that one. So save yourself the time, save yourself the headaches, and just leave that one out. But now we have that confirmation that all of these are safe to use. Okay, so hopefully this is all making sense and not going too fast. I'm trying to get through all of this content and just show you the good stuff so you know how to use it. But quickly, before we move on to the last tool here, if you are enjoying this video, please just give it a thumbs up. That's all I ask for, and let's get straight back to the video. So once we have done all of the work up to here, now we basically just need to turn all of that information into designs and then upload them to the print-on-demand websites. Now, I have used many graphic design tools over the years to create t-shirt templates. When I first started out, I was literally creating the designs by hand. Then I started going through all the tools to figure out which one works the best and most efficiently. And I always come back to Placeit. The main reason is because everything that you find on Placeit is copyright free and commercially usable. So you're not going to get in trouble with copyright infringement by using any of their elements, using their graphics, their templates, their fonts. It's all safe to use for print on demand. When you start to look at some other graphic design tools, they are very fuzzy about this. They don't tell you what is copyright free, what is not. And a lot of the times it's mixed into the library. So you may think you're using something that's copyright free. Once you upload that to the website, you may find out a couple months later that that got taken down because somebody owns the font or somebody owns that graphic that you used from that website. So anyways, let me show you how to use this. Again, this is going to be one of those that is a paid tool. Their pricing here is about $10 per month, and I do have another 15% off, which I will put the coupon code down in the description for the link for this one. So that'll bring you down to about $8.50 per month. Now, I will tell you that this is the annual pricing for this. So if you do sign up for a whole year, you're going to get this low of a price. I believe if you're signing up just month to month with no contract, this will initially be $15. And then with that coupon code in the description, it brings it down to about $12 per month. Okay, so with that being said, let's move on to how to actually use this tool. So what we want to do is we want to take these phrases, or we can pick out the ones that we like the best, and then we want to come over here and create designs with them. Now, looking through these, the one that I like the best that I'm going to use here to start with is caffeine and casts hooked on the good stuff. So let's just copy this, Command C, and we'll come back over to Placeit. And up top here, we're just going to type in phishing. And this is going to give us a general overview of different things for phishing that we can then intertwine the coffee concept into. So then on this left side here, once you've typed in your overall topic, it's going to show you both designs and it's going to show you mockups, which I'll talk about here in a second. But we want to come to the left side and find t-shirt designs and click on that. And what this is going to do is it's basically going to only show you the t-shirt designs that you can use. Now, you can choose any of these templates to go through. There's a ton, and you can kind of use your imagination real quickly to see where you would put the text here, what would look good for that design. But I'm just going to start with the first one here, and I'll show you how to customize these designs. So over on the left side, once you have selected a design and you're kind of in the editor here, you're going to see that there's different text boxes and they correspond to what is in this design. So if I just change this to my name, Greg, it's going to change it into the design. And what I love about these designs is that it kind of integrates it instantly. So the Greg went behind the fish here. So it just makes the design process so much easier. Now I'm going to start filling this out and kind of walk you through how this works here. So we're going to paste the slogan here and I'm going to take some of it that I don't want all of it in the first text box here. So I'm going to copy the second half of that and I'm going to put that down here and just take out any of the punctuation that we don't want in that design. So once you put this text in here, if you do want to move the text at all, you can move it around. You can even make it bigger if you want to keep customizing that design. If you want to go back, you want to undo something, just hit the back button right here. Or if you want to reset that to how it was in the beginning, you can just hit the reset layout and it'll put everything back to where it started. So if you do get it a little bit out of whack and you don't know how it started exactly, just hit the reset button. And then you can even hide different text boxes. So for instance, if you didn't want the established 1987, you can just hit the three dots and you can hit hide and it'll take that out of the design. design and then rework the design without it. I think it actually looks pretty good, so I'm just going to do show here. But then as you keep coming down here on this left side, you can hit edit and you can actually change what the graphic is. So this graphic in the middle of the fish, you can change to any other graphic from their library. And all of these, like I said, are copyright free. So you can use all of these different graphics without worrying about infringing on someone else's copyright. So this is just a couple pre-sorted designs that they think would be good in here, but you can search for anything. So you can search for fish and see what else comes up here. But if you just like what's in that design, you don't have to change it if it just works perfectly. Now, something else to mention is if you do have your own graphic or something that you want to upload, just hit the upload image right here and you can put something custom in there. So if you have a logo or you have anything that you want to add to a design, that's where you do that. Okay, so from here, just hit X and it keeps bringing us down in the design. So there's other elements in this design, like the kind of background trees in the back here. Well, what we can do is you can change that as well. So Placeit makes it easy to do this. You can just click and you can change that design to something else. All of these little changes that you're doing to the design is actually going to help you in print on demand because it's going to make your design uniquely yours. It really lowers the odds that anyone else is going to have a design that is exactly yours, which is just going to benefit you when you start uploading these to print on demand websites. And then the last thing on this left side is the arch color. So what is in the background here? If you want to change the colors of those, you can just come in and you can change all of the different colors of this kind of arch sequence that's going on in the back of this design. Okay, so right now we have a fully usable design. So there's one last step we need to do here, which is find the background color option, which is sometimes on the right side, most of the time on the left side. Just hit the background color, scroll to the bottom. There's going to be recent, default, colors. Make sure you're on colors, go all the way to the bottom and hit the checkerboard. Now, once you've used this before, it'll show up in your recents, but if you're finding it for the first time, that's where they've moved it down to. And then just hit X. And now you have a printable t-shirt design that's not going to print with this color rectangle in the background. So from here, everything's looking perfect. We have a design that's ready for print on demand. And now we're just going to hit download. Just give this 1 second to load. It's going to say processing your design and then it'll switch to you're ready to download it. Okay, so here we are. Click here to download. Just click that real quick. And then just like that, we've got this design saved to our computer. When you zoom in here, you can see that the quality of this design is great. So it'll print on a t-shirt with no issues. Okay, so one last step here is I'm going to click on the name here and I'm going to paste in the name of this design. So I'm going to go back here. I'm going to copy the full thing. And then I'm going to paste it right here and just click off of it and that will save it. This way, when you upload that design to the print on demand websites, they can kind of categorize this as something custom that you made. This is just a small thing that I like to do that I think helps. Okay, so if you use ChatGPT, Merchantformer, and Placeit, the ways that we've just used it could be an entire way of using those tools that would really help you in print on demand. But there's one last thing, kind of a bonus feature of how you can use Placeit. This is something that I used to do so much, but I've kind of switched my strategy a little bit. And what this is you can go back up top and you can type in phishing, and before clicking enter, switch this to mockups, and now go to search or click enter. And now you can actually put the design that we have just created on mockups. And what you can do with that photo is then you can then post that on social media, Pinterest, Instagram, Facebook, wherever you are doing advertising of your own for your print on demand store. These are great photos that you can actually post on those platforms that look like someone is actually wearing your design. So just scroll through here and see one of these that kind of matches what you are aiming for. I'm just going to go with something here to show you how this works. And then literally from here, just click on design and go import from downloads. And you will see the design that we just created here. Just select that. And then you can change the size and position of where this design is on the mockup. It shows you a little preview over here. I'm going to raise that up to the top so it's more in the chest. And then just hit crop. And it's going to show you a preview of what that looks like. And you can actually change the color of the shirt as well. So if you wanted to change that to a darker color or black, whatever color you wanted to do here. And then you have a photo of what looks like someone is actually wearing that design. Now, just before finishing this video, I just wanted you also to know that, as I quickly mentioned before, I don't do the advertising anymore with the mockups and things of that nature on social media. The strategy that I use now is focusing more on placing on the marketplace with those profitable sub niches and just letting those marketplaces do the marketing for you. It's a lot more passive. It's a lot easier. If you're interested in knowing that full process and that strategy of how to do print on demand, I'll put a link to that video down in the description. Again, it's here for free on YouTube. So hopefully you really enjoy that. All right, guys, I know that was a ton of information in this video, but hopefully it has saved you a ton of time and proves to be very helpful for your print on demand business. If you have any questions at all, just let me know down in the comments. Otherwise, I'll see you guys all in the next video.